Are you a podcaster or video creator looking to create really high quality, long form content where you interview another person and you want to create content that gets someone to stick, someone to listen or to watch all the way through? If that's you, I'm going to share my methodology with you today to overcome all the challenges and struggles. This is the kind of information I wish I knew over 11 years ago when I started the Social Media Marketing Podcast. My name is Michael Stelzner. I've been recording over 585 weekly episodes of the Social Media Marketing Podcast, and I know many of you that are watching are regular listeners. And what I want to do is peel back the curtain a little bit and share how I work with my guests before we do the interview so that we get incredible quality content. So first and foremost, what I do is I set up a pre-call with every single guest that has ever been on my podcast, including people like Seth Godin and Gary Vaynerchuk. And what I do in that pre-call is I negotiate with them to try to get something really high quality. The very first thing that I do when I get a new guest on the show is I explain who my target audience is. I lay out the demographics of the target audience and their global audience and help the person who's going to be on the show to understand who they're going to be talking to. The next thing that I do is I say, hey, I perceive you to be an expert in this area. I'd love to talk about this kind of topic. Is this okay with you? And sometimes they'll say, I'd prefer to talk about this other topic. And we negotiate that a little bit. And then we come to kind of a theme that's going to be the entire interview. Then what I do is I lay out with them some details that I think help prepare my guest to have a great experience on the show and also help my listeners have the best possible experience. And here's what I do. I'm going to break it down for you right now. The very first thing that I do with them is I say, hey, my show is about 45 minutes in length, and I spend the first 10 minutes exploring your story. I want my listeners to hear your story, and I want you to start wherever you want to start and work your way all the way up to the present. So recently I had a TikTok guest on the show, and I said, all right, what I'd love to do is I'd love to ask, how did you get into TikTok? And I'll start off the interview with, how'd you get into TikTok? Start wherever you want to start. We'll spend 10 minutes on this. The guest will know that we're going to spend 10 minutes on this. And what I encourage them to do is talk about their story all the way up to the present. And here's what I tell the guests that this does for everyone. First of all, some of my listeners are going to hear a little bit of my guest's story inside of their story, which draws people in. I also explain that story is a great way to latch people into the podcast. I also explain that when you share your story, this helps establish your credibility. I explain to them I don't want to know their story until the interview so that I can remain generally very curious. And then we do that for about 10 minutes in the 45-minute interview. And everybody has a great story to tell. It's just a matter of giving those guide rails to the guest. Then once we've done their story, the next 5 minutes of the interview on average is a why question. Because what I explain to my guests is my listeners might love you, they might love your story, but they might not be fully committed to what we're about to talk about. So for example, let's say the theme is how to use scarcity in your email marketing, okay? And maybe marketers aren't really hip on using scarcity. So what I tell my guest is, hey, explain to people why scarcity is so important. Persuade them why they want to keep listening. That's why my next question is always a why question. Because I know that some people that are listening to my podcast episode might be very skeptical about anything that we're talking about. And I want to lay that case out. Even if I've had other guests on the show talking about the exact same thing, what I haven't had is that individual with their backstory talking about why from their perspective. So we spend about 5 minutes on why. So we start with your story for 10 minutes, 5 minutes on why. We're one third of the way into a 45-minute interview. The remaining half an hour is where the magic happens. I explain to all of my guests that my show is a learning show. It's really meant to educate people on how to do things that maybe they're unfamiliar with. That's what differentiates my show from other people's shows, is we get into the how-to. We get into the tactical details. And this is where some of the mad science comes in. What I ask a lot of my guests is, hey, if we're talking about how to use scarcity in email marketing, I just made that up as a theme. First thing I'll say is, have you come up with like a methodology? Do you teach this to your students, or do you work with your clients or whatever it is? Or have you written a book on this or spoken about this on other shows, or have you come up with a system? And if they say no, then I'll say, all right, well then what if we can come up with something on the fly? We don't have to name it as a system, but ideally what I tell people is, it would be great for us to identify three themes that we want to talk about in the podcast interview under the topic, for example, email scarcity. And we'll spend a lot of time in this pre-call going back and forth over this. And those that have come up with these in advance that are used to talking about this, I tell them this little snippet. And I'm here to tell you, this might be one of the most valuable parts of the entire interview, so pay attention. What I tell people is that with long-form content, if you've already come up with a methodology and it has three or four steps, what we don't ever want to say in the interview is there are four steps and here they are. Step one, step two, step three, step four. Now we're going to go into the steps. The reason we don't ever want to do that is because there's a lot of psychology that goes on at play when you reveal in advance what you're about to talk about. People in their brain might say, oh, I know what that means. I'm going to stop listening. So instead, we can say there's four steps, and the first step is blank. And what that does is that sets up kind of a switch inside of people's brains. Okay, there's four. I don't know what they are. I'm going to keep listening so I can close the loop on that particular switch. So I try my best to train my guests to never reveal all of it up front. And that's really, really important. So we'll go through step number one, step number two, step number however many they are in the pre-interview. And then I'll ask them the following question. Okay, in step number one, what do you plan to talk about? I don't need to know the details, just the high levels. What do you plan to talk about? And then what I do is I prepare notes for my guests, and I say, when I say what's the first step, they're going to say, let's just hypothetically say in scarcity, the first one is to brainstorm ideas. Let's just say what that is. Okay, cool. So what do we plan to talk about under the category brainstorm ideas? And they'll say, well, let me think about that with you on the fly. Sometimes they'll say, I'll get back to you with that via email. And I'll say, no, no, no. We're here collaborating together. We're going to walk out of this discussion with a really clear outline. And they'll come up with some different things that they want to talk about. And I'll put those things in parentheses. And I'll do my best to not have them actually, in the pre-call with me, lay out all the details. Then I'll do it for the second and the third and however many steps there are. Then what I'll do is I'll back up the train and I'll say, okay, let's start from the beginning. We're going to start with your story. How'd you get into this? We're going to talk about why this is so important. Then we're going to get into step one. And under step one, we're going to talk about these things. And in step two, we're going to talk about these things. Am I hearing you correctly? And then a lot of times what will happen with our back and forth is they'll say, oh, you know what? Maybe this ought to be in this step. And we'll kind of co-collaborate to create a really strong outline. Now, when I actually move into the interview, some of my guests forget that we had an outline. But the good news about having this outline is I know that if they forget, I know what to ask them. And if you've listened to my podcast, you might have heard me say, you know, in our pre-call, we talked about this. Can you expand on this a little bit? So this gives me permission to trigger them if they've forgotten some of the steps. And by the way, before I actually start the interview, which is typically on a different day, I say, hey, do you have any concerns about the outline that we put together? This is really important. Some of them might say, yeah, you know what? I don't feel comfortable talking about these things that I thought I was going to talk about, so I'll take it out of the outline. And then when we hit start, what we have is we have what feels like a natural conversation. The guest has done their homework at the very least with me in a 45 minute to 60 minute pre-call, and I can guide them to things that they might skip. And by the time we're done with the entire interview, at the very end, I'll ask, where can we discover more about you? And that's where I'll ask, like, what's your favorite social platform? And then, you know, I'll even guide my guests ahead of time, like, hey, you might want to maybe have some stuff prepared for people in advance. So this is my model. If you've listened or watched the podcast, you've noticed there's a certain kind of structure to it. And I can tell you that this works because I get messages from people almost every day saying the following: I binge listen to your podcast every single day. Now, I know that's not possible because I've only got 585 episodes and are once a week. But what that tells me is they're in a deep learning mode when they actually listen to the podcast interview. In addition, I also know this really works because a lot of the people who have been on my podcast become presenters at Social Media Marketing World. And part of the funness about all of this is there's this intertwinedness, if you will, between people being a guest on my show and people ultimately coming to Social Media Marketing World because people listen to my podcast interview. They get to know these brilliant experts and they want to come learn more from them at the conference. So that is my methodology. I'm curious, if you have your own show that you've been doing for a very long period of time, do you do things differently than this? Do you find this intriguing? I would love to hear your thoughts. My name again is Michael Stelzner. Thank you so much for watching this video with me today. Have a great one.